Alright, so this is going to be something a little bit different. Aerial photography! Or really just seeing the world from a perspective not normally accessible to humans is what got me into multirotors in the first place. Along the way, I got lost in all the other fun aspects of the hobby, but lately I've been thinking of incorporating something of that original spark into my videos. So, here it goes! Many of you have asked me about the MJX X600's ability to lift various types of cameras for the purpose of aerial photography. Does it manage an 8-to-8 keychain camera, a Mobius camera, a GoPro camera? The short answer to those questions are yes, yes, and probably no, but I would like to go into a little bit more detail than that. The Mobius is probably the go-to camera for most mini quadcopter enthusiasts. It retails for about $70. I don't own a Mobius, but I recently bought a RunCam HD. It's a newer product from a different manufacturer, which costs a little less, around $55, but looks and supposedly performs very much like the Mobius. I decided to try it out with the MJX 600. Thus, this video is also a comment on that product. What you see here is captured by the RunCam HD mounted to the MJX X600. Well, I say mounted, but I actually just put two pieces of Velcro on the back of the camera and two pieces underneath the MJX X600, on the battery hatch where the FPV thingamajig would normally go. I tried to put it in such a way as to not offset the center of gravity of the Hexacopter. It's very close, but ultimately, the landing gear of the MJX X600 doesn't quite cover the height of the RunCam HD. There's only a half a centimeter or so missing, so what I ended up doing was attaching pieces of some foam I got as packaging with some other product to the bottom of the landing gear with a glue gun. Works really well. The RunCam HD weighs around 40 grams, and as it turns out, the X600 handles this payload with ease. Both maneuverability and flight time is virtually unaffected. I got over 9 minutes of flight on the stock battery with this setup. The motors didn't sound strained and there was absolutely no problem getting off the ground or ascending. Remember that the RunCam HD is almost identical to the Mobius in terms of weight and dimensions, so using that camera would work equally well. According to the same logic, the smaller and lighter 8-to-8 keychain cam would also work no problem. I did notice the Hex was more likely to enter into Vortex Ring State, or VRS, also known as the Wobble of Death. This is when the rotorcraft descends into its own downwash, the turbulent air being forced down by the blades. It triggers under certain circumstances and has little to do with the specifics or quality of the aircraft. If anything, more with the weight of the camera and the flight style you'd be employing when doing aerial photography. I didn't know any of this beforehand, I just knew it as that weird thing that happens sometimes when you fly. It turns out there's a lot of useful information out there, both on and off YouTube. But back to the video itself. So this is the raw, unprocessed footage from the RunCam HD. I hadn't played around with any of the settings at this point, so this is how you can expect it to perform straight out of the box with the latest firmware update. The camera has two main video modes, 1080p at 30 frames per second and 720p at 60 frames per second. This is captured in the former. Before you draw any conclusions about picture quality, remember that YouTube can sometimes introduce compression artifacts to the video, especially if you're watching in lower resolutions. Overall, I'm happy with the resulting video quality. It definitely feels like a step up from my 8-to-8 keychain camera. Sharpness is great at 1080p and colors look vivid, albeit possibly a little oversaturated. Like all cameras I've used of this type, it has some problem finding an appropriate brightness level when there's a lot of contrast in the frame, like towards the beginning of this clip. It was not dark under the trees by any means, but the contrasting brightness of the surrounding fields made the camera misadjust somewhat. Later, I noticed the camera has a WDR, wide dynamic range setting, which could potentially remedy this, but I've yet to test it. Toward the later part of the clip, you'll probably also notice some jello effect, which is the informal name for wobble caused by a rolling shutter. I think you'll know what it is when you see it. I won't go into great technical detail, but this generally unwanted effect comes from a combination of a vibrating camera and the way most digital sensors capture individual video frames. The effect can be prevented either by using simple, possibly DIY vibration dampening camera mount, or with various software tools in post-processing. Here, I have done neither in order to show you the actual unaltered footage. Pure video quality aside, the RunCam HD came very nicely packaged. Highlights of the contents included a clear, concise instruction manual, a sturdy and very tight-fitting camera mount, and even some FPV cable for you guys who are into that. No question about what the target demographic is, eh? Using the camera should be simple enough, but with only one indicator light to tell you what's going on, it's actually quite confusing. Learn by heart what the different combination of flashes means, or keep the instruction manual handy, Alright, I think that's all I had to say. I'll leave you now with the rest of this roughly 9-minute long flight. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and if you have any corrections or questions about what I've talked about, leave a comment below. See you soon in another video. Bye bye.